Hey guys, welcome to my tutorial on the say command. Now the say command is pretty easy to use. All you have to do is press /say, press space, and then type in whatever you want, and then press enter. And there it says exactly that. Now you're probably thinking, well, I can just press T and type whatever I want anyway, and that will work. But the advantage of this is that it works with command blocks. Now in order to give yourself a command block, you need to type in /give at, which is created by pressing shift and 2, P-C-O-M-M-A-N-D command block. Yeah, you get the idea. It gives you a command block, and what you can do is place it down and then type in your say command, and then type in whatever you want to say, and then when you power it, it will say that in the side. Now there are some cool applications of this. You can go say at all, and it's going to say all players on the server, right, which is just me. I can also go say at P, which says the closest player on the server, which is me. You can also say at R, which says a random player on the server, and then the most important, say at E, which says every entity by their name on the server. So things can get a bit complicated sometimes. If I want to say all creepers, what I can do is go /say at E, because creepers aren't players, they are called entities. And then I'm going to do this open square bracket. I'm going to type in type equals creeper with a capital letter. If you don't put in a capital letter, it won't work. Let me show you. Nothing. The entity type creeper is invalid, so it needs to be capitalized. And as you can see, it says the creepers by name, Creeper and Bob. Now why is the other one called Bob? Well, it's pretty simple. All I've done is I've spawned in a creeper, got myself an anvil or used a command. You grab yourself your name tag. There are other ways of doing this, by the way, but this is the survival friendly method. And I'm just going to type in John right here. I'm going to name the creeper John. And when I do the same command again, I'm pressing T and up, and then enter, it's going to say John, Creeper, and Bob. Now, what if I only wanted to call this by name? Well, I can go say at E, name equals, let's say, John. And now, it's only going to say this guy. Now, if I kill it, and type in the command again, it's going to say that that player cannot be found. It gets more interesting though. R equals means within radius. So if I place down, say, 5 creepers, and I go /say at E, open square bracket, R equals 3, and then close it, it's only going to say 3 creepers and myself, even though that there's 5 here. Why? It's because, well, I activated the command here. Everything happens from the perspective of your feet, and I've gone 1, 2, 3, so it's only selected these creepers. Now, what if I said something like M equals 3? Well, basically, it's going to say every entity except the ones within 3 blocks of me, as you can tell by this. Now, you can also combine them. So what if I go RM equals 3, but R equals 10? Ah, that's looking a bit better. So it's only targeting these 3 creepers back here now, which is very, very powerful. Now, there's another problem. If I just were to write R equals 10, it's going to target me as well. I don't want me to be targeted, so what I can do is place a comma here and go type equals creeper, and then press enter, and it's going to target all creepers within a radius of 10. Now that's all well and good, but what if I wanted a bit more? What if there were Endermen here and I wanted to target the 2 types of moles? Well, that's also pretty simple, except I have to say type equals not player. How do I say not? With an exclamation mark, shift 1, not player. And then it's going to say everything that's within a radius of 10 that is not a player. So that's pretty useful. Wait, it gets even better. We can use C, when we're using at E only, to target the nearest entity. So if I say, say at E, C equals 1, it's going to target me because I am the nearest entity to myself. So let's go C equals 1, comma, type equals not player. And it's going to target the nearest entity that's not a player, in this case, a creeper. If I were to type in C equals 5, it's going to target the closest 5 entities to me. If I were to type in 5 negative, C equals negative 5, it's actually going to target the 5 furthest entities away from me. So long as the chunk is loaded, there could be things a million bajillion blocks away from me that the world isn't recognizing, but, and therefore, it won't target them. And finally, what if I wanted to say a random entity? Well, all I have to do is type in say at r, alright, and then I add in my square brackets, I go type equals creeper, and then close my square brackets, and it's just going to say a random creeper. Now let's constantly execute this command. Okay, so you can tell it's random because it's been targeting all the other creepers now, and then it's also targeted Bob once as well. You can also target multiple entities at a time by putting comma, C equals whatever number. So now it's just going to target 3 random creepers. So this is very powerful. So, I hope you learned a thing or two about targeting entities and the say command. What we've learned today is not exclusive to the say command. In fact, it happens with pretty much every command. And there are tons and tons of things that we haven't covered still, which are reserved for future videos. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.